truly impressionable odyssey of childhood anguish, the nature adaptation of Where the Wild Things Are is based on the popular 1963 children's book. Every roar and interaction and flourish of imagination is rooted in the melancholy of a lost grip on innocence. It's like one final scream aimed towards a world that will eventually defeat a child's opposition. What I find so moving and so off-putting about Spike Jonze's film is its confidence in portraying an unforgiving portrait of the end of a moment in time, innocence lost, and yet this one is crafted with such care. What Jonze has done with this tale of a disgruntled boy is pure magic. Not only does he understand the essence of the original story, he manages to expand upon it and provide more depth. Children will appreciate the visual interpretation of the well-known monsters, and adults will be touched by the nuances of the story. It's not for the kids per se, but it is most definitely about them, and that lies at the root of understanding the power of this seemingly simple story. Where the Wild Things Are isn't specifically geared towards a younger audience, as much as it is towards the older generations who live through the circumstances we see on screen. I was, as much as I'm sure many of us were, Max at one point. I was the loner who played with sticks and rocks instead of whatever the latest toy every other kid in class was drooling over. I was content in creating my own alternate type of reality where anything I could think of was possible, and I felt perfectly content in that world. A world where I wasn't the slowest person on the field, the most oblivious kid in school. The failure, the outcast, sometimes fantasies provide relief from an overbearing reality that can crush the soul. And sometimes fantasies are an absolute necessity to help face the struggles of everyday realities. With the basics of Maurice Sendak's story set into motion, the fantasy world which Spike Jonze is employing under his own eyes is the perfect setting for Sendak's creation. In addition to the set design which so perfectly fits into this atmosphere, what we also have are voice performances that emulate love and compassion all around, whether they range from the late James Gandolfini to Lauren Ambrose. Each character immerses themselves into Spike Jonze's taste for creativity. The clear standout is the low-key performance of Young Max Records and how it creates a loving atmosphere to shroud itself in. It soon becomes clear that Max is not simply a misunderstood kid wearing a wolf costume, but he can be any misfit in society who may be trying to search for a place of belonging. Where the Wild Things Are's portrait of Max's internal quest is made all the more beautiful and resonant for an older generation. Adding more to this wondrous world comes Karen O and Carter Burwell's soundtrack, which lovingly embraces a childlike tone, adding more to the playfulness the film creates, because it holds together a logic that weaves much like that of a child's imagination. It keeps flowing. And under Jonze's direction, together with Record's dedicated performance, everything fits so perfectly in place. The term family film is thrown around a hell of a lot in this post-Pixar CG-dominated era of cinema, but rarely do the examples thrown under its banner encompass everything that Where the Wild Things Are does. Children will bask in the magical realism, and adults will be transported to an ethereal point from their youth where imagination truly ruled. If a film for everyone ever really existed, Where the Wild Things Are is it. Jonze uses these visual styles to stimulate a response in the viewer who grew up reading this story. Cynics who can be so hard to impress are unable to appreciate the most well-done coming-of-age films. This film focuses on that feeling which remains dormant for many years, one you've become desensitized to, that overwhelming depressing reality that we ran from as children. It strikes a nerve that could, for some, be considered a melancholy kind of nostalgia. For others, like me, it hits me even deeper, reminding me of a time when childlike imaginative creativity flowed from my mind unlike any time since. For this reason, above all others, Where the Wild Things Are is a more adult-oriented masterpiece that expands its sources' themes into complex ponderings of realism, escapism, and childhood freedom long lost in a rowboat on the other side of a dense, magical forest. Oh. every Friday for new movie videos. Please like, share, and subscribe. Comment down below what other movies you would like me to do videos on. Thank you, Mom, for editing the scripts for my movie essays. I appreciate you. Till next time, thanks for watching. Catch you on the flip side.